special one presented by the Writers Guild of Great Britain. Many in the room know who they are. At home, you might not know about the Writers Guild, but they're an august organisation of writers with their own motto, which is, only if I get a car home. If you find Lucas and Walliams a bit common but aren't ready for the full toffery of Armstrong and Miller, there's only one double act for you. Please welcome Mitchell and Webb. How great it is to see Mitchell. So lovely to see you together, because we see you on your own quite a lot on TV. I mean, I love you on Would I Lie to You. Congratulations on 10 o'clock live. I thought that was great. I love it when I see you on... You've been Question Time. You've been on panel shows on a regular basis. You're always great in those. I think, am I right in thinking, I saw you in the background of a recent Antiques Roadshow and you had a particularly ornate vase.
That was me.
Which I think was criminally undervalued, but you dealt with it in your own, that kind of way you have. It's just brilliant. And that, no matter what you speak on, it seems to me you could any subject, you can keep David, any subject, and you talk brilliantly on it. Oh, I don't know how you do it. I don't know how you do it. Do you like watching on TV as much as we do?
It's been made very clear to me that I'm very lucky to be here.
I'll leave you to it.
David, thank you. David and I met the two recipients of this award a very long time ago, and it's thanks to their efforts that we're now seen as the Compo and Clegg of Channel 4.
Yes, the sitcom they're best known for, Peep Show, has now been recommissioned 8/30ths as many times as Last of the Summer Wine, and is, some would argue, sometimes funnier.
They made me murder a dog, and David simulate being raped.
Yes. They've also written all or part of The Old Guys, Magicians, The Thick of It and Four Lions.
They're brilliant, they're hard-working and they're lovely, so why do they do such terrible things to the characters they create? Should have brought my spectacles.
Yeah. Winners of this year's Writers Guild of Great Britain Award, please lose all sense of proportion as you show your appreciation for...
Jesse Armstrong and Sam Bain!
Sam and Jesse met on a creative writing course at Manchester University. They went on to write for Michael Parkinson and The Big Breakfast. They knew that Peep Show was their big chance. Of course, any similarities between the two of them and their characters are purely coincidental. Although I'm sure they've been tempted at times to wheel each other's heads.
Wow, well, this show probably gets double the viewing figures of anything we've actually written. So, anyone who is not familiar with our work, we actually wrote The Office, The Simpsons and Fawlty Towers.
I was surprised to see nothing for whites this evening. The show, not the racial group. which is cleaning up again as a racial group, which is good, I guess.
Our careers have already exceeded our expectations, and we've got a lot of people we want to thank to make it possible. So if you want to have a nap, come back in about 30 seconds. But we wouldn't be here without...
First, we'd like to thank David and Robert, who are our collaborators, friends, and the funniest people I've ever met. They're wonderful. Linda Seifert, Kathy King, Gareth Edwards, Phil Clark, Andrew O'Connor, and I'd like to say thanks to Armando and Simon Blackwell and the other Thick of It writers.
And Kevin Ligo, Ian Morris, Shane Allen, Andrew Newman, Robert Popper, Kathy King, Becky Martin, Andrew O'Connor, Chris Morris, and just want to thanks to my wonderful mother and my amazing wife who are here as well. Thanks, Wendy.
And I want to say thanks to my friends who I grew up with, who I think, if anyone makes you funny, those are the people, and to my lovely wife and my dear parents who are here. I want to say, you know, we're pathetically grateful for this meaningless bauble.
And finally, hopefully there'll be lots of young, aspiring writers watching this at home. So to those guys, I just want to say, in your face, losers.
Gentlemen, thank you so much. Now the award for the best female TV comic. Yes, is that part of the evening where our Taliban viewers pop out and put on the kettle? This one, a brilliant comedy actress, that's Sharon Horgan, and with her, TV's top sexy astronomer, who's currently mapping the moons orbiting Jupiter. It is Dr. Brian Cox. are lovely. We'll get to Brian in a minute, but Sharon, as well as being a very gifted comic, as well as being a writer and an actor, I know you are also something of an amateur science buff.
Am I? Yeah. I love science. All the sciences.
Would we, without putting you on the spot, a science little spot quiz?
Don't ask me
for Sharon,
science.
A little quiz for something a bit tricky, but something that she might
okay,
know.
What's
on.
The sign of the time component of the Minkowski distance measure in Einstein's space-time?
Is it minus sign?
Correct.
Wow, what about
that? Otherwise, the theory would be non-causal, wouldn't it? I think.
Bang on.
I don't know.
Channel 4.
You know that.
I did know that.
Education.
I love Brian. He's like the lickable face of science, isn't he, ladies and gentlemen? But you know what I love about Brian as well? It's reassuring because, you know, we panic and I always worry about the end of the planet and maybe a big bit of space rock coming down, but that's not likely to happen, is it?
It's inevitable.
Is it?
It's absolutely inevitable.
When any sort of time frame you can give us?
Could be tomorrow.
Brian Cox, ladies and gentlemen, here at the British Comedy Awards.
I can say that because
I can smile and everybody just laughs.
Yeah,
we are going to die.
And the winner is... It's Joe Brown. Yeah!
Joe is a multi-talented stand-up comic, actress, author and cake connoisseur. She's put her 10 years' experience as a psychiatric nurse to good use in the BBC 4 hospital comedy Getting On, where she plays nurse Kim Wilde. And as she says on the show, I'm Kim Wilde, not the singer. Best female comic, Joe Brown.
I'm sorry, Shappy and Sarah, but I suspect the reason I've got this is I'm a lot older than you are. I know I am, because I'm probably the only person in the room that wet myself when I coughed this evening. I realise I'm getting a lot older. It's probably my last chance. I did actually go to my local supermarket recently, and as they rang up the price on the till, underneath it said, pensioner discount. I'm 53, for fuck's sake. Anyway, 15p's 15p, isn't it? I'd like to say thank you very much indeed to everyone who I've worked with that I liked. And they all know who they are. And as for the people that were horrible to me and journalists, and thank you very much to my mum and dad and my husband and my lovely children and to all the people whose table I'm sitting on that have let me eat everything off this plate. Been brilliant. Thanks a lot. Cheers.
Well done, Brian and Sharon. I love Joe Brown. Our next award is for Best Sitcom. And now, a great sitcom is so hard to get right. In fact, a successful sitcom in showbiz is rarer than hearing the words, "Hello, Dom Jolly, we're giving you a second series." A very beautiful and talented actress, Alice Eve, and a stand-up comedian, 2010 documentary maker, and if they were in jail together, he would be Stephen Fry's bitch. It's Alan Davis. You want to go in the middle?
Yeah, I'm in the middle.
I'd love to see you. Alice, you look fabulous this evening. Thank you so much. Normally, I would say, what spectacular hair, but how can we choose between the two? Yeah. It's always been a crown glory, Alan.
When you two were talking backstage, I couldn't tell who was who with the bouncing heads.
Yeah, how about that? You never thought you'd hear that, did you?
None of us know how we feel about that. Come forward to the microphone. Don't be shy. It's not like you.
Hi, everyone. How are you?
It's Alan Davis.
Have a grand day. Isn't that marvellous?
It's marvellous. Alan, Alice, let's get on with it.
So, the winner is, for the best sitcom, The Inbetweeners.
Well, best new TV comedy in 2008, and now best sitcom in 2010. The Inbetweeners is a hilarious teenage comedy to anyone who hasn't got teenage children, that is. If you have got teenagers, it's a hell of a learning curve. And we can look forward to The Inbetweeners film later this year. Best sitcom, The Inbetweeners.
Congratulations. A popular name. Congratulations.
I wish Kevin Bishop was here. Because that would make this funny rather than a list of thank yous. Thank you to the audience who watched the show. Yeah, that's you up there. Yeah, shameless. Shameless in a way for me. And thank you to Angela Jane at E4 and Danny who was there. And I may. And yeah, everyone's. I actually mixed feelings about this because on the way here I said to the guys I'd get Minge tattooed on my foot if we won, so. Bit of a blow. But thank you very much, and thanks to E4, Shane Allen, Neris Evans, and to the other person at E4. So thank you to them.
Did we thank Caroline Leddy?
Caroline Leddy, yeah, well, it's Caroline Leddy.
She really is the driving force behind the show.
And also, by the way, just quickly, February the 3rd, on iTunes, you can buy The Boys going to see rude places around Britain for Comic Relief, so please do support
Comic Relief. The Inbetweeners, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, young men. Congratulations. Thank you.